Happy Thanksgiving and welcome back, everybody. I'm your host, Massimo, and I'm here with
Patrick.
In NFL news, the Carolina Panthers have signed Cam Newton. He was their star quarterback for 9 years until 2019 when he suffered many injuries and was released by them. Newton played for the New England Patriots during the 2020-21 season. He then became a free agent. And 9 weeks into the season, he was re-signed by the Carolina Panthers due to QB complications with Sam Darnold. Cam and the Panthers were able to pull out a big win against the Cardinals. Another big signing in the NFL, the Los Angeles Rams signed Odell Beckham Jr. to a one-year deal for $4.5 million. Rams looking to go back to the Super Bowl this year. Seahawks wide receiver DK Metcalf was ejected last week against the Green Bay Packers. The NFL is evaluating if the consequences will be a fine or a suspension.
Massimo, who are the three best teams right now in the NFL?
I'm going to go with the Cardinals, Rams, and the Packers. Their depth and their teams are amazing. It was a close call between the Rams and the Titans, but I think since the Rams picked up both Von Miller and Odell Beckham Jr., they have the upper hand.
This week, PSG player and Argentina national team legend Lionel Messi has been announced fit and healthy to play against Brazil. This will take place against Neymar on Tuesday. Furthermore, Cristiano Ronaldo, along with Portugal, had a devastating loss to Serbia, ending their qualification hopes for the 2022 World Cup. Lastly, Dani Alves has signed with Barcelona at 38 years of age and has signed a €1 a week contract, making him the lowest paid professional soccer player ever.
In NBA news, the Warriors' 7-game win streak came to an end with a loss to the Hornets.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next episode.
Happy Thanksgiving! Welcome back, everybody. I'm your host, Mossimo, and I'm here with
Patrick.
On Tuesday, November 2nd, the Atlanta Braves won the World Series for the first time since 1995. The Braves overcame many injuries and acquired their World Series MVP, Jorge Soler. He had 3 go-ahead homers and joined Babe Ruth, Lou Gehrig, Gene Tenerentz, Curtis Granderson, and George Springer to have 3 or more go-ahead homers in the World Series. And he became the second Cuban-born player to win the award. Moving on.
This week, NFL player Henry Ruggs was involved in a car crash caused by his intoxication that night. He rear-ended the back of a Toyota RAV4, resulting in the death of a 23-year-old female. Later, Henry Ruggs was charged with DUI, resulting in 2 to 20 years in prison. Furthermore, Green Bay Packers QB Aaron Rodgers has tested positive for COVID-19. It has been announced that he will not play Week 9 against the Kansas City Chiefs.
Brooklyn Nets star Kevin Durant will serve as the co-CEO of Infinite Accusation Corp. Durant has made over $300 million in his basketball career, and he just signed a 4-year extension that will end in 2026, and he would make $194.2 million. The new NHL team, the Seattle Kraken, are off to a slow start with 10 games played, 3 wins, 6 losses, and 1 overtime loss. The next game is against the Buffalo Sabres.
This weekend, English Premier League team Tottenham Hotspurs has hired Antonio, former Inter Milan manager, to change his organization into a winning team. Furthermore, Cristiano Ronaldo has saved Manchester United again, scoring 2 goals against Atlanta and ending with a 2-2 draw.
To wrap up this week's episode, a Minnesota man charged with illegally streaming MLB, NFL, NHL, and NBA games for profit. The man's name is Joshua Brody, who also tried to export $150,000 from MLB Street. His nickname has been charged with 5 criminal counts. That's our podcast. Thanks for tuning in. And welcome back to the second episode of Hot Takes. I'm your host, Massimo, and I'm joined by my co-host,
Patrick.
The Los Angeles Dodgers lost in Game 6 of the NLCS, which allowed the Atlanta Braves to move on to play in the World Series for the first time since 1999. They won their first game and lost their second due to defensive errors. Game 3 will be tomorrow in Atlanta. the Braves looking to get their mojo back after an ugly loss. In the NFL, Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs are looking to turn things around with a win against the Giants, who are 2-5. Things are looking bad once again for the Giants this year.
Ever since the old Eli Manning and their supposedly franchise quarterback, the Giants have been terrible.
I agree 100%. Giants owner John Mara needs to get his franchise together right now. I don't know if it's their front office, their players, or coach, but whatever it is, things need to change if they want to win. A big rivalry game in college football is happening this weekend between the 7-0 Michigan State Spartans and the 7-0 Michigan Wolverines. If you know, you know. Number 20, Penn State lost to the unranked Illinois in 9 overtimes, 20-18 last Saturday. That was a great game.
This week, women's national soccer player Carly Lloyd retired after an amazing international career. She has achieved 316 games and 134 goals. She scored her last two goals against Paraguay. Because of this, she surpassed the third all-time goal scorer in U.S. history. Furthermore, Xavi, Barcelona legend, has accepted the head coach job for Barcelona.
I don't know soccer, but do you think this will help Barcelona?
Yes, I believe Xavi will turn this around. Lastly, an upsetting loss for Everton against Watford this last week. Watford beat Everton 5-2, shocking the Premier League. For basketball, Hornets player LaMelo Ball is shocking the NBA with his skill. He is averaging about 15 points per game and 5 rebounds per game. Furthermore, the two LA teams, the Lakers and the Clippers, are off to a rough start, losing both of their first two games of the NBA season.
I agree 100%. LaMelo Ball has definitely been off to a hot start. Westbrook so far is a misfit to the Lakers. And that was our show. See you next time. Thanks for tuning in with us. With your host, Patrick and Massimo. Every week, we'll be giving you sports news from all over the country. And MLB News, the Los Angeles Dodgers defeated the Giants in a 5-game series and moved on to the championship series against the Braves. They lost their first two games in Atlanta due to walk-offs, one by Austin Riley and the other by Edwin Rosario, but the Dodgers won their first game in LA with the final score of 6-5 from a big Bellinger blast to tie the game in the eighth inning. In the American League, the Houston Astros tied the series 2-2 in Game 4. Kike Hernandez heating up the postseason, batting .500 with 5 homers, 4 doubles, 9 RBIs, and 9 runs scored, along with a .514 on-base percentage. October really is the best month for sports. Patrick, who do you have winning the World Series this year?
I think the Braves are going to win this year.
I disagree, but okay. Let's move on to some NFL news. The Arizona Cardinals look to stay undefeated with a win against the Texans this weekend. Raiders coach John Gruden resigned due to emails containing racist, homophobic, and misogynistic messages. The Raiders hired their special team coordinator to be their interim head coach. The NBA started yesterday, October 19th, with 2 games, Warriors-Lakers, and the reigning champs from last year, the Milwaukee Bucks, took on the Brooklyn Nets. The Bucks and Warriors took a win home with them to start the season off strong.
This past week, the United States men's national soccer team beat Costa Rica with a score of 2-1. They had an amazing game with 64% possession, while Costa Rica had 36%. They now move on to Mexico on November 12th. This will be a difficult game considering the talented squad. Furthermore, PSG player Lionel Messi scored 2 goals and Mbappe scoring 1 against RB Leipzig, giving PSG a 3-2 win this week. In conclusion, Newcastle has been bought by a Saudi group and has been announced as the richest owner to own a club. The Newcastle owner has a reported collective wealth of $320 billion. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next week.